A horse with a sparkling horn that rises from its forehead grazes on a nearby hilltop. Unicorn! Okay, sorry. Hello, lovelies! Cuckoo Cuckoo here, and I'm really excited to show off this game that I just got. I have been bribing myself. I've made myself a sticker chart. And when I got 50 stickers, I was allowed to buy this game. So I'm really excited to be playing it, and I'm establishing good habits. So it's good times. I'm just gonna do like a one episode introduction to the game so you guys can see if you find it interesting. I think this is actually a text-based game. I'm not sure there are any graphics. So it's gonna be a lot of me reading, but I think it'll be really fun. I'm really excited about the story. I love Robin Hood with all of my soul. As you guys know, I am writing a Robin Hood inspired book. So this counts as research, right? Right? Yes. We're going with yes on that one. So let's get into it. King Richard the Lionheart is gone to the Crusades, along with most of England's able-bodied men, and has left the kingdom in the hands of his brother, the wicked Prince John. Meanwhile, the prince's ambitious crony, the Sheriff of Nottingham, terrorizes the countryside. As you strive against the evil sheriff, your every choice will change your fate. But fate can be fickle or forgiving. Just how much so depends on you. Choose your difficulty level. Story mode. The state of England is a chaos waiting to be relieved by your actions. Skilled warriors, battle-hardened from years of war and unrest, are ready to join your band. Gold traveling through Sherwood is lightly guarded. Normal. The best of England is away at the Crusades, but a core group of skilled yeomen remain in the country, ready to fight injustice at your call. Gold traveling through Sherwood is moderately guarded. Challenging. You're just another band of ruffians, while the sheriff's forces are highly trained and ride regular patrols around Sherwood. Gold traveling through Sherwood is heavily guarded. The factions of England eye you with distrust, and the challenges you'll face may demand hard choices. Impossible! The sheriff and his company of elite soldiers wrap Sherwood in an iron fist while only untrained peasants are desperate enough to join your cause. You begin with nothing. May God have mercy on your soul. I don't know. This is always. I hate choosing difficulty level of a game I've never played because I don't know, like, exactly how hard it is. And story mode sounds appealing just because I want to focus on the story, but I'm gonna go with normal. We're gonna go with normal. England, 1192, a quiet spring evening. Bring me the Locksley brat, the sheriff's bellow echoes through the walls of your home. The one named Robin, the rest are yours. Hobnailed boots shake the walls on all sides as soldiers fill the house. You need to get out of here. You don't have much time. I sneak out the back entrance through the kitchen. I leap from the window and race for the stables. The guards don't know me. I throw a cloak around my shoulders and blend in with the household staff. Ooh. I like the idea of being stealthy and kind of more con artisty, but that does sound really risky. Like, these definitely increase in risk. I'm gonna go with the guards don't know me. I throw a cloak around my shoulders and blend in with the household staff. I'm gonna die my first click, aren't I? You reach into your closet. I disguise myself as a manservant. I want to play as a male Robin. You finish your disguise with a wide-brimmed hat, step into the hall, and join a group of fleeing servants. Unnoticed in the crowd, you escape from the main house to the chapel. Father Timothy walks among his congregation. Fear not, my children, for though the sheriff does strike against this house, he shall not violate the sanctity of the church. So long as you remain within, you are safe. He notices you. Robin, I'm glad to see you well. Father Timothy, can you talk down the sheriff before this goes too far? The sheriff is after me, though I've done nothing wrong. Can you help me escape? We can't just sit here. We need to organize a resistance. I think I'm more focused on escaping than organizing a resistance. I don't want to put everyone else in danger. I mean, eventually I'm going to start a band of merry men, right? But is now the time? I'm feeling really independent at the moment. I mean, can you help me escape? I'm still asking for help, but I want to get myself away and then I can organize. I just don't feel good about organizing a resistance right now. The sheriff is after me, though I have done nothing wrong. Can you help me escape? I can and will. Father Timothy nods towards the back. A secret passage behind the altar opens up into the forest's edge. Is there anything you need before you go? I escaped with nothing. Any gold or silver you can spare will get me far. A letter of introduction would ease my passage. Anyone who can run should come with me. I fear for the safety of this community. Not but your blessing, Father. I think I'm gonna say anyone who can run should come with me. I didn't want to organize a resistance, but I do want to help people get out of here. Anyone who can run should come with me. I fear for the safety of this community. Oh, I got 15 men and 2 power. Cool. You've gained a measure of power for saving the people of Loxley. Power is often gained through selfless or heroic actions, as well as through the steady struggle against the sheriff. Power can eventually be used to start special projects, gain favor with the factions beyond Sherwood, and influence the larger world beyond Sherwood Forest. I'm really excited. This game is pretty intricate. Okay. Father Timothy helps you gather a small group. I must believe the church is sacrosanct. He pauses. Yet it would be irresponsible not to send as many away while I still can. There's a heavy thumping on the church doors. Open up, in the name of the sheriff! You climb the ladder behind the altar into the earth and take a long, winding passage that dumps you out into a hillside beyond the fields. You smell smoke on the air, and the sky is shot red with devouring flames. Something went terribly wrong, and now flames devour the only home you've ever known. The night passes. Okay, I gained 186 gold, some renown, some more men. You've garnered the allegiance of several merry men, as they will come to be known. Among other things, they can help you win battles, waylay caravans, and steal the crown's taxes. Your merry men have a variety of duties, including hunting, training, and scouting, but a certain number are available for tasks or missions at any time. Once assigned to a task, they return slowly over time. The next day dawns cool and clear, though smoke from the smoldering ruins of your home still blackens the distant horizon. You have a bounty on your head, doubtless, and it will only grow should you continue to evade capture. Meanwhile, pursuit will come, likely in the form of Baskervilles, the sheriff's special hounds bred to the size of a horse. I do not remember that from the original legends. I like it. But for now, you have other concerns. You need food, weapons, shelter. Voices clamor nearby. The families from the church huddle together. A woman named Anna introduces herself and volunteers to help organize the survivors. Other refugees found you during the night. They've gathered what little they saved from their homes in the center of camp, including a fair amount of gold. The people you rescued look to you for direction. The horizon calls, cold and clear. I need to find food, I need weapons. I gather those who followed me through the night, we need to talk. Distance is my friend, I travel. Sherwood beckons, the dark safety of its trees studded with danger and mystery. Okay, I'm torn because part of me just wants to get to Sherwood as fast as possible, and part of me's like, I need to feed these people ASAP. And I need to arm myself. Ah, bah, sha. I think food needs to be, like, the number one priority. No one is gonna function, no one's gonna fight until we're all fed. Your eyes travel over the rolling hills, track signs of isolated farmsteads. The year is still young, but there is bounty to be had if you know where to look. The new green crowns of Sherwood Forest rise not half a league off, the King's Forest, full of deer and other game. Awesome, I got to choose Sherwood and food at the same time. I send my followers to forage for food among the nearby hills. I travel to a nearby farm to purchase or beg for food. I brave Sherwood Forest. There will be venison tonight. I send my followers to poach in Sherwood Forest. I reconsider my options. Now I want to brave Sherwood. I'm going to go get me some venison. Let's do this. You begin to salivate, thinking on how you will roast a deer when you're hit with an ugly realization. You have no bow, no arrows with which to hunt. Okay, we should have started with weapons. I reconsider my options. The horizon calls cold and clear. I need weapons. You consider again the cold, hard fact that the sheriff's men and beasts will soon be after you. You need a sword and a bow to defend yourself. There's a friendly smithy nearby. I can bargain or possibly beg for weapons. Sherwood Forest is rife with bandits. If I'm careful, I can ambush one of them and take their weapons. I mean, if there's a friendly smithy, why would I attack bandits with no weapons? That just seems dumb. You meet with a young smith, Brown Adam. I thought I saw smoke this morning. It's bad business what the sheriff does, but I'd rather not get caught up in it. I have both bow and sword, but they will cost you. This is an opportunity to spend your resources, gold renown men, to access special options in the game. Gold and renown are used while your men will return slowly from their assignments over time. Okay, so we can't afford to pay it in gold. We don't have enough renown. We just have to leave. Well, so much for being a friendly smithy. You leave empty-handed, with nothing but lost time to show for your effort. Your eyes track across the landscape, watching for signs of the sheriff's men. There, a flash of white against the cerulean sky. A horse with a sparkling horn that rises from its forehead grazes on a nearby hilltop. Unicorn! Okay, sorry. A unicorn! I approach cautiously. The world is full of wonders, but I have practical matters which need attending. Shoot! I want to be practical, but I want to chase the unicorn. This is a hard choice. I'm struggling a little bit. I have to approach the unicorn. I can't resist. Maybe Robin could, but I can't. Be practical. I can't. A unicorn. I approach cautiously. The unicorn's nostrils flare. Catch your scent. It fixes you with a gimlet eye just beyond arm's reach. Are you a virgin? The beast speaks soft, feminine, and clear in the king's English. Of course! I hope you are saving yourself for true love. The unicorn angles its horn towards your heart. Perhaps we shall meet again. There, but for the grace of God, go I. You have been granted a measure of grace. When you find yourself down and out, or need a little extra help, you might have the opportunity to choose a grace option. While there are sometimes alternate solutions to a situation, grace options will always help you out of your current situation in the best possible way. Be warned, grace can be used once and will not return before the turning of the seasons. The unicorn rears up on its hind legs and vanishes twixt the passing of a cloud. No sign is left on the return of the sun. You shake your head and continue on your way, left only with a lingering sense of wonder. Yeah, I regret nothing. That was awesome. So I'm going to leave off there with Knocked: True Tales of Robin Hood. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I am having so much fun playing this game. I'm going to go play some more. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next episode. Bye!